China has been sending rockets into space more than any other country lately. It is also the second nation with the highest budget put into the space program, right after the US. Considering that the Chinese space program began seriously only 18 years ago, the growth is nothing short of astronomical, and for some reason, the Chinese space progress is giving the US sleepless nights. But what exactly does the US have to worry about? If they do have something to worry about, how will it affect the world in general? Well, you will find out in just a second, but first, please don't forget to subscribe to our channel, Futurephile, to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Every year, the US intelligence communities lists a report called ATA, which stands for Annual Threat Assessment. On April 9th, 2021, North Korea, Russia, and, surprisingly, global environment, the other threat was China's push for global power. The paragraph regarding space stated, Beijing is working to match or exceed US capabilities in space to gain the military, economic, and prestige benefits that Washington has accrued from space leadership. The main concerns for the US are, 1. A space station in low Earth orbit is to be operational in the next 4 years. 2. More Chinese lunar explorations to build a research station on the moon. 3. China's presence on Mars. Does the rivalry between China and the US, especially during the last 15 years, blow the space thing out of proportion? Before talking about threats or exaggerations, we first have to know if China's current space activities could be actual aggression in a military context or just a matter of political prestige. So let's see a bit more into details where China is concentrating its forces. But most importantly, why is she doing it? The moon. If the moon was where America won the first space race, China had to start from there. They decided to do it by doing something that was never done before. In 2018, China reached the far side of the moon with the mission Chang'e 4. But this mission has a wider plan behind it. The first great goal of China is to build a research station on the surface of the moon. They chose a location called the Southern Pole because provisions estimated that there would be water in the form of ice through the craters. But there's more than that. If finding water is just a possibility, the presence of the helium-3 is now a fact. Helium-3 is a non-radioactive isotope that can be utilized in nuclear fusion. Earth has a low quantity of it estimated at about 15 tons. But on the moon, well, the situation changes a little. There are more than 5 million tons of helium-3 a few meters under the moon's surface. If nuclear power stations on the Earth had 100 tons per year, the entire planet would finally be carbon-free. 3/4 of the entire energy produced in China still depends on coal. The more the population rises, the more this becomes a serious issue. It's no wonder why China is seriously looking to mine helium-3 in this decade and send it back to Earth. The landing of the Chang'e 4 is the furthest step that any country has made so far in the direction. The economic impact of a carbon-free world would be the biggest opportunity for mankind, which will directly impact the cost of helium-3, with a single ton costing around $1 billion. The moon has now become the largest asset. Both China and the US knows it. Now it is just a matter of who will be faster. The Chinese space station. Next on the list of US concerns, we have the Chinese space station. On April 29th, 2021, China achieved another big step forward. The dream of having a stable orbiting space station around the Earth is becoming a true reality. This move shouldn't come as a surprise to anyone, because China has officially banned from the International Space Station program since 2011. The name of the Chinese space station project is Tiangong, which means heavenly place. The station is made out of 3 main core modules that will be completed and assembled after 3 separate launches. The one launched on April 29th was the first and most crucial for the mission. China has also sent 3 astronauts to Tiangong. They will be testing equipment, life supply systems, and conducting experiments, leaving room for many other human missions. By the end of the next year, China wants to finish the project. Once completed, the size will be approximately a fifth of the International Space Station. This is actually good news for many experts because the world gave China a good reason to not trash low Earth orbit with space junk. But for experts like Peter Gerritsen, a retired US Air Force officer, this China's move could imply a civil-military integration at all levels. China on Mars. Thanks to the notoriety on social media and public opinion, we are now used to thinking that Elon Musk's SpaceX will be the main hope to reach the surface of Mars, making mankind officially a transplanetary species. But what about China on the red planet? On July 23, 2020, the Chinese rocket Long March 5 successfully left the ground, leaving the Earth's orbit. The rocket carried the Taiwanian probe and the Zhurong rover. 7 months later, on February 10, 2021, the probe entered Martian orbit. On May 15th, the Zhurong rover touched the surface of Mars. The success of this mission is crucial for two main reasons. First, this was the first Chinese mission to the red planet, and it landed as planned, breaking what is called the Martian curse. It refers to the success rate of the Mars missions throughout history, which has been a rough 40%. Second, China did it all at the first shot. Mars exploration consists of three main phases: orbiting, landing, and patrolling. China has achieved all of them at their first launch. For years, the US was the only nation that landed a rover down there. In less than 15 years, China did it. This fact has proven the quick and astonishing exponential curve of the learning of the Chinese space program. The US can do nothing but stay and observe what will be next. Even the words of the new NASA administrator, Bill Nelson, were quite uncertain on what to do, describing China simply as a very aggressive competitor. Why is China doing it? Let's forget a second about the prestige and the will to show technological superiority. Are there any other reasons why China is putting so much effort and budget into this second historical space race? Of course they are. The space industry is now worth $345 billion. That's because our everyday technology and lifestyle depend on it. Internet connection, mapping systems, online orders, all of this is possible thanks to an accurate satellite system that gives live tracking positions around the globe. Paradoxically, the same system and principle that you use to order from a fast food restaurant are the same that guides ballistic missiles and other military operations. China has been developing a new system for decades, and now it is finally ready to be used for the Chinese market. It is called Baidao, and it was designed to offer fast internet connection and other useful services with a system of 27 satellites that orbit around the Earth. Now that we have realized space dominance also means a military and commercial advantage, one last question still begs to be asked. Is it good or bad? I mean, is the Chinese space race a good or a bad thing? Well, it highly depends on who you are asking. Sure, the title of this video states red flag for the US, but let's try to see things from another perspective. Since the first space race in the 60s, the intense rivalry and competition between the US and the Soviet Union made the United States place $6 billion in 1966 for the NASA budget. Nowadays, due to inflation, this amount corresponds to $47 billion. Without this fact and the competition pressure, it was highly improbable that the first man landed successfully on the moon that soon. Here is the thing. When other people are trying to compete for the same goal, it comes naturally for humans to put more effort into a single project. The former Vice President of the United States, Mike Pence, stated, "We are in a space race, just like we were in the 60s, and the stakes are even higher." Could this be the right time that mankind will step foot on Mars after so much talking? And okay, I get it. If you are from China, you hope the first man or woman landing to be Chinese. If you are from the US, you hope for the exact opposite. But despite all the political moves and rivalries, what the space race has taught us is that human beings work better when they work together. Take the project of the Apollo Soyuz, for example. It consisted of two different capsules, one with three American astronauts and the other with two Soviet cosmonauts. The goal of the mission was to meet in space and then docking together. This successfully happened on July 19, 1975, and the world saw live the first international handshake in space between an American astronaut and a Soviet cosmonaut. This event was the stepping stone for a new collaboration. If the same thing will happen on the red planet among men or women or of whatever nationality, would it be so important who came first? So what do you think about the Chinese space progress? Do you think the competition between China and US is unnecessary, and they should rather focus on collaboration instead? If you liked watching this video, you may also like watching the video on China's Starship clone. See you there.